Hello, so welcome back, everyone. Anthwolf here with even more Star Wars The Old Republic. Playing as Phaedron here, my agent. And where we last left off, we had just completed the 8th and second last chapter of the Knights of the Eternal Throne expansion, known as End Times. Unfortunately, as you can see, the Alliance landing is being in better condition. And we lost a fair few members of the Alliance in the assault by the Eternal Empire, including Vett. Seems we had to choose between her or Taurian. One way or the other, Vaylin was going to try and kill someone to break our resolve. But in return, we managed to kill the Eternal Empress. Unfortunately, it seems now the Eternal Fleet is out of control and is raining death and destruction on whatever world they manage to be orbiting. We need to place our butt upon the Eternal Throne and hopefully put an end to their destructive tendencies, shall we say. Before we begin Chapter 9, the Eternal Throne itself, let us have a look at our mail once again. Galt here was in a somewhat positive mood. He overheard Lana talking about the Emperor's vault that was on Nathema. The thing is, he's heard about vaults. It's supposed to be more than just one, each filled with priceless artifacts. Taurian here, acknowledging that we were faced with an impossible choice by Vaylin. Mandalorians don't fear death, especially not in battle. If I fall fighting our enemies, then I have served my purpose. But don't mistake this for a death wish. I want to live, and you have given me that gift. He promises to honor Vett's noble sacrifice. And of course, Galt then sends us another message. His time together with Vett. Vett, of course, being a companion, the first companion of a Sith warrior. It sure feels like the galaxy has gotten a little bit dimmer now that she's gone. See, Senia has messaged us. Because she's not ready to talk about her daughter's passing. If it wasn't for Senia, if it wasn't for Falcorian, and their choices to maybe send her to Nathema, maybe she wouldn't have been so broken. But in the end, she made her decisions. And of course, Ferron, we have a holocommunication from Zakuul's surface. Think like a daughter sending her father a message. The Eternal Fleet's gone mad. Reinforces that we have to try and put a stop to it.
You are ready.
Commander, what's wrong?
The visions are getting stronger. Either I ate something bad, or my bond with Valkorion's growing deeper by the minute.
He may be toying with you. Or perhaps you glimpsed something he didn't want you to see.
Whatever he pulls, I'll be ready. Did you bring the holocron?
I've been studying it since we escaped Nathema. The relic's function remains a mystery, but its power is undeniable. If it can protect you from Valkorion.
Do you actually believe that dusty trinket can harm me?
Keep playing nice, and we won't have to find out.
I have no reason to betray you. Seek the Eternal Throne. We have sacrificed too much to turn on each other now.
I felt his presence. How can you stand it?
Valkorion's not the first person to hijack my mind. Though he's certainly more talkative than Watcher X.
I read the report. It's why I dissolved all brainwashing programs in Sith intelligence. Be careful Valkorion doesn't push you past your breaking point.
Commander, to the bridge.
Your crew's ready. It's time. Here, this will help.
So we are en route to Zakuul.
This is it, people. The day we secure the Eternal Throne.
Empress Vaylin has fallen. In her absence, the Eternal Fleet rampages across known space, threatening to wipe out all life in the galaxy. There's only one way to stop them. We must seize the throne.
Problem is, those warships are blockading Zakuul and bombing the city to rubble.
The fleet will stop at nothing to protect the throne. No ship can break their blockade, not even to flee for safety.
You know the Eternal Fleet better than anyone, Arcaan. How do we break their blockade?
You don't. The fleet was built on technology beyond anything in the Alliance.
Except my favorite ship. If I reroute power to the Gravestone shields, we'll crack that blockade.
Then it's settled. When do we reach Zakuul?
Now! Nice knowing you, Commander.
Break that blockade.
Everyone, to your battle stations! For the Alliance! Commander, if anything happens to me, it was worth every moment I've spent with you.
I love you, Lana.
You taste of adrenaline. It suits you.
We will join your fight, Commander.
I started this war. Now, I'll help you end it.
Let's take the throne and save your homeworld.
For Zakuul!
For the Alliance!
Here we go. The Spire has certainly seen better days. We have Arcaan and Senya with us once again. Pushing forward.
A favorite tactic among the Knights of Zakuul.
When I was in charge, the Knights had better aim.
Bullseye.
Indozal reporting for duty. Full of vigor and raring to serve the Alliance.
Though that blast shot may have dislocated my shoulder.
I knew we could count on you. Now, give the signal and send the rebels to join the fight.
My pleasure, Outlander. My compatriots borrowed artillery from the local militia. They'll begin raining fire any moment now, I'm sure of it.
You and your friends will all have a place in the Alliance once this is over.
I'm getting all misty. Now, if you'll excuse me, I must plan for your ascension to the throne. It will be my grandest party yet.
I understand the skytroopers might be automated, but why are the knights still fighting us?
Victory is almost upon us, but you ignore a closer threat. A disgraced former emperor, and his mother, a knight turned traitor. Strike down my family. And you will face no competition for the throne.
One more interruption, and I'll give Arcaan the throne just to spite you.
You would not dare. Zakuul burns. The Republic suffers. Only you can pacify the throne and end this cycle of violence.
And yet everyone's still trying to stop me. Man, that's still not allowed to be. Thank you. We made it.
My throne. I took my brother's life here, provoked Vaylin's anger, abandoned the people of Zakuul. I am not fit to rule. I never was.
You are following Valkorion's twisted example, but you're a better man than he ever was.
And you are even stronger. Claim the throne, Commander. You have earned it.
The fleet stopped.
The fleet has gone quiet.
You did it, Commander.
Well done. After years of strife, you have become Emperor of Zakuul, Commander of the Fleet, and heir to the Eternal Throne.
Your family's caused enough damage. I won't let the throne fall into the wrong hands again.
Neither will I.
No!
Stop, Father! I once offered you mercy in this very room, but you refused to bow. Now, you have no choice.
I'm ready for whatever you're...
Bow.
As you command, my Emperor.
You're an exemplary pawn. One I forged into a vessel of supreme power, worthy of preserving my spirit. Now I take your body as my own. And rule once more as the immortal Emperor.
You can't do this, Valkorion.
I already have.
Wake up. Wake up.
Well,
what happened?
Huh. This is new.
Who am I?
You're the Alliance Commander, formerly Cypher 9 and agent of the Sith Empire. You wear Valkorian skin, but you're the same person you always were.
This isn't the first time I've had someone rewire my brain. Whatever tricks Valkorion's pulling, he can't deceive me.
Your mind isn't controlled. It's broken. Valkorion shattered your mind and tossed you into the abyss of your psyche. He thinks you're dead, but you survived by assuming his form. Find the holocron. Save yourself.
Oh! Wonderful. We're back here again. What abilities do we have as Valkorion? Oh, we can call down a force storm if we so wish. We can steal the life force from our enemies. From all enemies in range. Wow. 1,000 meter range. Our memories are they his?
Valkorion has poisoned your mind. Cleanse your corrupted memories, or you'll be trapped here forever.
Cleanse our memories. We've seen roads like this before, when we were dealing with the Dread Masters.
When you helped my sons track me down, I refused to surrender to mortality. My spirit invaded your mind in search of a new host. You resisted. In your mind, I conducted experiments to save my curiosity. I offered you my power, and you accepted. I pushed you to defy Arcaan, but instead you recruited him. I pretended to abandon you on Odessa, but my departure was a ruse. Trapped in your mind, I silently observed how you behaved in my absence. Your strength grew, your vulnerabilities festered. In time, my curiosity eroded, and a plan began to take shape. I would hollow out your mind, take possession of your body, and ascend to the Eternal Throne. But first, I require new weapons to conquer your psyche.
New weapons.
had enough to prove. By striking her down, you unleashed her spirit and gave me the key to your ruin.
Which is why you were so eager for us to strike Vaylin down. Probably why he was so eager for us to deal with Arcaan as well. Oh, the throne.
Take the holocron. Save yourself.
The Outlander's alive.
Father conquered his mind, but he's fighting back.
Look out!
You persist. Impressive.
Skull. Then I woke up here, in your body.
I intended to destroy your mind. That you survive is unexpected, but correctable. When you struck down Vaylin, I consumed her essence. Her spirit is now mine to command.
Let me go, or I'll chop you into little pieces.
Submit, my child.
As you wish.
First you have me kill Vaylin. Then you enslave her spirit.
You sound disturbed.
This is cruel, Valkorion, even for you.
Save your judgment and prepare for your downfall.
I have one last surprise for you, Tenebrae.
Father.
Your mother should have obeyed my orders and drowned you when she had the chance.
I ended Mother's suffering long ago, but your torment is just beginning.
Your boy caged you for millennia. Take your revenge.
Through Tenebrae's death, I will earn my freedom.
I killed you once, Father. Now, my offspring will share the pleasure. Annihilate them!
Okay, yeah, Vaylin. Attacks against her will increase the instability of her powers.
Join me in death! Drenneth pierced my armor at the cost of his life. Soon, you will follow him into oblivion. Rise, my child.
I am yours to command, father.
How about we make things interesting?
The Outlander.
I have a better idea, father. The Outlander's toy set me free.
Take the holocron, Arcaan. The Outlander needs you.
Father's too strong.
You've proven yourself stronger. Show him the man you've become.
Arcaan. Arcaan.
I won't let you face him alone.
Touchy. Vaylin, strike down the brother who betrayed you, and the outlander who stole your life away.
Father makes a good point, for once.
Attack us and forever be Valkorion's slave. Join us and fight for the freedom he stole from you as a child. It's your choice.
Choice? I could get used to that.
Such a waste.
Now I see why you locked me away, Father. You knew I'd surpass you. You were afraid. I'm going to enjoy watching you squirm.
You have won over my children. Now you will all be consumed by eternity!
Oh, here we go. Ooh, oh yes! We have the holocron at our disposal. We can focus the power of the holocron to align ourselves to the light or dark side of the force. We need to weaken him first, of course. Then we may use the holocron upon him. Here we go.
You really think you can face the full power of the Eternal Emperor?
Oh, he's aligned himself to the dark side of the Force. He's broke, he's free.
This can't be happening!
Arcaan and Vaylin of Air went on a journey, it seems. Keep weakening him. Oh, there you go. It's no longer aligned.
This can't be happening! Enough!
Kneel before the Dragon of Zakuul.
No, that only works against Vaylin.
You've spent 100 lifetimes putting people in cages. Here's yours.
Impossible!
Kneel, Father! Kneel before the Dragon of Zakuul!
It's over. Let go.
Senya.
You've turned your back on this family for the last time.
I am the Immortal Emperor. You cannot defeat me.
Sooner or later, death was always going to catch up with you.
Husband.
Father.
Monster!
Give your family the freedom they deserve.
A god has no family. Before I graced you with my presence, you were nothing but motes of filth, drowning in the chaos of the void. And you, a pawn of the Sith Empire, chasing hollow conspiracies. I forged you into a being worthy of the Eternal Throne. Without me, you are nothing.
Wrong again, Valkorion. It's you who needed me. Now you're alone, and nothing can save you from the fate you deserve.
Remember me when your alliance burns to ash.
Valkorion.
Go. Join my brother.
Ha! How does it feel to be erased from the galaxy?
It's over.
You defeated Valkorion. Once and for all.
Valkorion's risen from the grave more times than I can count. Are we sure he won't return again?
I no longer feel my father's presence. We will never see him again.
Now we can look to the future. I've opened a system-wide holo channel. The galaxy's ready to meet the new Emperor.
I'm no emperor. People of the galaxy, the war is over. The Eternal Fleet is pacified.
Today marks the end of the Eternal Empire. The people of Zakuul are now free to rule themselves. I will transform the throne into a beacon of peace, dedicated to helping Zakuul recover from a war that nearly destroyed us all.
We faced the full might of the Eternal Fleet. Watched cities fall, friends die. We have suffered for the last time. The Eternal Fleet will now serve as a benevolent armada, delivering supplies, transporting refugees, and healing the damage this war inflicted. We must now look forward, beyond our homes, to the stars that surround us. This will be our new frontier, as we work together to rebuild the galaxy. By trusting in each other, we begin a new era in galactic history. The Age of the Eternal Alliance.
Missing the party.
Funny, I thought you passed out on the dance floor.
I got a second wind. Let me guess, you saw the intelligence reports.
The Republic's preparing for war.
And the Sith Empire's not far behind. So much for our friendly pact with Ascena.
The Eternal Alliance is only hours old, but already I sense dark forces massing against us. Uprising sparking across the galaxy.
We will defeat them.
Tomorrow. Tonight we celebrate.
Damn right we celebrate. And so ends the night of the Eternal Throne expansion. I'm sure a few of you would have preferred I maybe have taken the position of Emperor of the Eternal Alliance. I was tempted. I was very, very tempted, I have to admit. But that could have its, well, either way, we'd have issues. Either way, whether or not we would declare ourselves emperor or not. But we are still a leader of our own faction, this new Eternal Alliance. We have a new alert. Oh. Oh. Interesting. I see. Huh. Very well. We certainly have new directions in which we can go. There are bits of mail slowly pouring in. And of course, I do believe we have a new series of interlude bits of content known as Uprisings. Uprisings, I believe, are similar to Flashpoints that we may be able to complete in Story, Veteran, and Master Mode. I have never looked at a single Uprising. Maybe we'll take a look at a few. before we start looking into those new Alliance alerts and whatever is in the future for Phaedron here as the commander of the Eternal Alliance. We will take a break here though. Feel free to leave a comment if you so wish. We have come a long way with this series, and there is still plenty more to come. Bloody hell, there is still plenty more to come. But we're starting to get into areas that I will not be greatly familiar with. I believe the next major event, I've only been and involved myself in twice before. And from there, we will likely be making choices that I've never chosen before. So things are certainly going to be interesting for Vaydrin. I do have my time with Caiaphas Kane to keep myself occupied when I'm not here with our agent. And as I've alluded to before, there is another series somewhat in the works. Still in the very, very early stages. And that will keep me occupied, because that is just another way of playing Star Wars The Old Republic. Another roleplay idea, which is vastly different from both Vaydrin and Caiaphas Kane. So depending on my mood at a certain time of day, or when I wish to record, if I want to play some Star Wars The Old Republic, but I feel particularly vindictive, I could always, I have another character, let's just put it that way, that I can record content with. But that is giving you a little bit of a hint, maybe a hint for the future. We shall see. But for Vaydrin here, we will likely look at the Alliance alerts, we'll likely look at a few uprisings, though I do believe I'll have to get over to the Imperial fleet to take a look at those. And then we'll get ourselves ready to continue with the story arc going forward. Which makes me think I need to get back on board the Phantom and make use of the mission console once again. But no, sincerely, thank you all for joining me if you've made it this far in the series. I know I can ramble on a little bit, but no, I appreciate everyone who actually gives their time and watches the series along with me playing the game, of course. And hopefully you'll continue to do so in the future. But no, if you want to leave a comment, you are more than welcome to. Sincerely, like, I hope to hear from you and what your thoughts are. And hopefully I'll see you as we continue the series going forward. Until then, though, take care. Bye-bye now.